हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट यूनिट, लॉज ऑफ मोशन। बिफोर दिस वी हैव डन दैट मोशन, एंड इन मोशन देयर वी हैव डन देयर इज अ थ्री टॉपिक डिफरेंट। देन फर्स्ट इज अ बेसिक ऑफ द रिलेटेड टू द मोशन, दैट डिस्टेंस, डिस्प्लेसमेंट, वेलोसिटी, स्पीड। इन नेक्स्ट चैप्टर वी हैव डन अबाउट देयर वेक्टर, एंड इन नेक्स्ट वी हैव डन दैट इज द प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन। नाउ नेक्स्ट यूनिट इज अबाउट द लॉज ऑफ मोशन। इन दिस यूनिट वी विल रीड अबाउट दीज आर डिफरेंट लॉज ऑफ मोशन दैट इज अ गिवन बाय द न्यूटन, एंड अबाउट द फोर्स दैट इफ एनी ऑब्जेक्ट वी आर टेकिंग देन हाउ मच फोर्स विल एक्ट, हाउ वी कैन बैलेंस दैट फोर्स। दिस वी विल रीड इन दिस चैप्टर। नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम फर्स्ट टॉपिक, फोर्स। What is force? Force, it is the external effort in form of push or pull which change or tends to change the state of the rest or state of the uniform motion or state of its direction. Force, that is the push or pull which we are applying on any body, that which tends, which is the tends to change the property, change the state of the body if it is in rest or in motion, that in change its direction, that is a force. It is external effort in form of push or pull which changes or tends to change the state of rest or state of uniform motion or to change its direction, that is force. Next topic, inertia. What is inertia? Inertia is the inability of a body to change by itself its state of rest or motion along the straight line or along the direction, that is inertia. The inability without external force, that is the ability of a body to change by itself, not any external effort, but itself, its state of rest or of uniform motion along a straight line or to change the direction of motion is known as inertia. That is the inability of a body to change itself, not any external effort, that is inertia. For example, if you are standing in a bus, as bus start moving, then bus will not apply for on us, but on self we will move forward, we will fall forward direction, that is due to inertia. There is a three types of inertia. In 9th class also you have done about this, so now we are doing basic of this one. Inertia of rest, second inertia of motion, third inertia of direction. There is a three type of the inertia. First is a inertia of rest. Inertia of rest, the ability of a body to change itself its state of rest. The inability of a body to change by itself its state of rest is known as inertia of rest. Clear? For example we can write here. For example, when we shake the branch, of the tree, the fruits fall down due to inertia of rest. When we shake the tree, then fruits will fall down due to inertia of rest, because tree is not applying force, but they are falling on self. We are applying force on a tree, then tree is shaking, but fruit fall down on self. That is inertia. Next, inertia of motion. That the ability of a body to change its uniform motion is known as inertia of motion. Clear? That if we are standing in the bus, then if bus is in motion, then if it will stop, then what happened? We will fall in forward direction. That is the inertia due to motion. Next, inertia of direction. If the direction is changing on self, that is inertia of direction. The ability of a body to change by itself the direction of motion is known as inertia of direction. That is inertia of direction. Clear? This is inertia having three type: inertia of the rest, inertia due to motion, inertia due to direction. There is a three type of inertia. Next topic, our linear momentum. What is the linear momentum? The quantity of motion that contain in a body is called linear motion. If any object is moving, that is having some velocity and mass, that will be momentum. The quantity of motion contained in a body is called linear momentum. that is linear momentum. That mathematical quantity that we can write there, P, that is a vector quantity, equal to M into V. V also is vector quantity. Clear now? Where it is linear momentum and V is velocity and M is mass of an object. Clear? Now if we are taking here, then it is scalar or vector, it is vector quantity that we can find direction as well as the magnitude. And SI unit of the linear momentum, from formula we can derive it, mass is kg and velocity is meter per second. That's why this one is the SI unit. Clear now? Linear momentum. Now, relation between linear kinetic energy and linear momentum. Relation between kinetic energy and linear momentum. Why we are writing here linear momentum? Because their momentum also having two type, that is a linear and angular. In rotational motion that will be angular momentum, but in this linear motion that will be linear momentum. Now we will find their relation between kinetic energy and linear momentum. Kinetic energy, that is the half mv square. Everyone know about it. Kinetic energy equal to half mv square, where m is the mass and v is the velocity. Clear? Now relation, how we can find it? That as we know, p equal to mv. Now only I told you, p momentum, m is mass and v is the velocity, then p equal to m into v. Now from here we can write there first equation, this second equation. From equation first, then kinetic energy we can write there half. From first equation multiply and divide by m square v square by m. Here we have multiply and divide by m. There is no change. If we are multiply and divide the same term up and down, then we can write it, then m square v square we can write from equation second, kinetic energy equal to half, this we can write here v square, that is m. Clear now? Then kinetic energy equal to half v square by m. Clear? That is the relation between kinetic energy and momentum. Next our topic, Newton's law. Thereby near Newton there is a three law is given. Newton first law, Newton second law, Newton third law. Three laws is given. First law motion. In first law that told by the Newton that a body continue will be in same position if we are not applying there any external force. That means if there is external force is zero, then object will be remain in same position. If it is in rest position, then it will remain in rest. If it is moving in uniform motion, then it continuously moving in uniform motion. Clear? Then we can write it if external according to this law, if external force is zero, then a body remain in same position that is if it is in rest then it will remain rest and if it is in uniform motion then it will remain in uniform motion. That is the Newton's first law. That is the telling about if external force is zero, then their position, change in position of any object will be remain same. If that object is in rest, then it will remain in rest because their external force is zero. If it is moving in uniform motion already, then if we are not applying any force, then it will remain in the uniform motion. Clear now? Now next law, that is a Newton's second law. That is a Newton's second law. In second law, that is a told by the Newton that if we are applying some external force, then what happened? In first law, that their external force is zero, then there is no change in position. In second law, that if we are applying their external force, that is the directly proportional to the rate of change of the linear momentum. That is the Newton's second law. Then we can write it according to this law. The net external force acting on a body is always directly proportional to rate of change of linear momentum. This change is take place in direction of the applied force, and this change takes place in direction of applied force. That is, we can write their external force is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Like this we will write, that is a directly proportional to the rate of change of linear momentum. Rate of change means with respect to time. As we remove this proportional sign, then we will take here a constant, that is k. We can write here constant, then where this constant value we are taking 1, then we can write there f equal to dp by dt. Now as we know, then p is, as we know, p is mp, mass into velocity. Then put here, we can write here d mv by dt. Now from here we can write there m dv by dt, and f equal to m dv by dt. As we know that rate of change of velocity, that is known as the acceleration, that is f equal to ma. Clear now? It measure the force, it measure the amount of force. That is a Newton's second law, f equal to ma. Clear? Up to this topic you have complete in your fair notebook, and try to solve this derivation in rough notebook. Okay.